Hi students, I am Pooja and today I will be discussing with you the first chapter of Standard 5 Maths, that is large numbers. So let's get started. So mainly in this chapter I have categorized it into four parts. In the first part I will be dealing with Indian and international system. The second part will be consisting of compact and expanded form. In the third part, we will learn how to find the successors and predecessors of any number. And in the last part, we will see how to arrange numbers in ascending and descending order. So, first, let us take the first part, that is Indian number system. So, for our convenience to read large numbers, we divide large numbers into periods. P-E-R-I-O-D-S. Okay, periods. So what are these periods? You will see that once we look into the place value chart of any number system. First, we will take the place value chart of Indian number system. See, I have already written the place value chart of the Indian number system, and here you see in this chart it is broadly divided into four parts. This is ones, this is thousands, this is lakhs, and this is crores. So these are the periods that I was talking about. So ones, thousands, lakhs, and crores, these are the periods. And then each of this period is again divided into further categories. So this, see, in this ones we have another three categories, that is, those are hundreds, tens, ones. Under the thousands we have 10,000, thousands. Under lakhs we have lakhs and 10 lakhs. Under crores we have crores and 10 crores. Now we will see the number value, or rather the place value of each of this. Okay, so in this ones, in this one, this will consist of only a single digit, that is 1. The next one, that is 10, it will have 10. And if you see carefully what is basically happening here, we are just adding zeros to each of these groups where, as we are moving from the right hand side to the left hand side. See, this is 1. 10 is added here, this has become 10. Again 10 added here, this has become 100. And this goes on. This has become 1000, this is 10,000, and it will go on. So again, if we try to look a bit more carefully in this, so can we say that each of this is getting multiplied by 10 as we are moving from right to left? Yes, of course it is. How it is happening? See, in this 10, can we say that 1 tens is equals to 10 ones? See, here, if we multiply 10 with this 1, it becomes what? It becomes 10. So, this is 10. Again, if we multiply 10 with this 10, then it becomes what? It becomes 100, and this is 100. So now if I try to write here, that is 100, that will be equal to 10 tens. For your understanding, if I just break it down, this is 10, and tens means what? Another 10. That is equals to 100. Now can we tally? See, this is 100. This is also 100. And this will go on. If you try to do it, I'll give the rest of the part as homework. You try to do it up to crores, 10 crores. You try to find out 10 crores is equals to how many crores. And if you still want to go further, you try to find out 10 crores is equals to how many lakhs, thousands, hundreds, and like that. So here, let's just complete the chart. I have said up to here, that is 3 digit. This is 100. This is 1000. This is 10,000. See, this is 3 zeros. This is 4 zeros. Here we have 5 zeros. Let's just check once. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is under lakhs. We have 5 zeros. 10 lakhs will be having 6 zeros. This is 7 zeros. This is 8. This is 8 zeros. And if we just count the number of digits, it will be 1 digit. This is 2 digit. 1 and 1 zero. This is 2 digit. And this will go on. And 10 crores will be having 9 digits. Okay, so this was mainly the place value chart of Indian number system. Okay, now that we have already learned about the Indian number system, let's take an example and try to read out the number in Indian number system. I will take any random example. So this is a random example that I have taken. So what are the steps that we will follow when we will read out any number in any number system? For this, I am taking Indian number system. So first step will be, first we will put commas or spaces, but I generally prefer putting commas. So we will be using commas. So first, write down the number. This is given in your question. Write down the number as it is. It is given in your question. 837241. Now we have already learned about the periods, that the first period will be consisting of 3 digits. That ones is consisting of 3 digits. So the first comma will be after 3 digits. That is here. And after the first comma, the rest of the commas will be after every 2 digits. So the next comma will be here and it will be here. You understood why? Because in this number system, see, the ones was consisting of 3 digits, the thousands was consisting of 2 digits, lakhs was consisting of 2 digits, and crores was consisting of 2 digits. That's why we are putting the first comma after 3 digits, and after every 2 digits we are putting the next commas. Let's come back to the example now. So here I have already given the commas, and next what we will do, we will write down the place values of each of these digits in just shorthand above each of the numbers. So here, this is ones, this is tens, this is hundreds, this is thousand, this is 10,000, this is lakh, this is 10 lakh, and this is crore. Understood. Now can we read out the number? Yes, we can read out the number. But while reading out the number, we will take the digits in the periods together. What I mean by this is, see, 2 and 8, this belong to the same period, that is lakhs. 3 and 7, this belong to the same period, that is 1000. So if I try reading out the number now, it will be 7 crore 28 lakh 37,241. I'll repeat it once more. The number will be read out as 7 crore 28 lakh 37,241. Okay, now next we will discuss about the international number system. So I have already drawn the international number system. So let's see. So this is the place value chart of international number system. Like the previous one, here also we have periods, and the periods here are ones, thousands and millions. And under ones we have ones, tens, hundreds. Under thousand we have 1,000, 10,000 and 100,000. Under millions we have 1,000,000, 10,000,000 and 100,000,000. The rule will be same. See, this is, it will start with 1, and as I move from right hand side to the left hand side, each of the number will be having one extra zero, like the previous number system in Indian number system. So this is 1, this is 10 added, this is 10, this is 100, this is 1000. Similarly, it goes on. So that means what? 10 is being multiplied to the 1 in the right hand side group. See, 1 into 10, 1 into 10, here 1 into 10, like previously we have already discussed. Now, one more thing here, that is, in this international place value chart, we have one more group beside this million, that is billions. If I just write, try writing it, that it will be 1 billion, B-I-L-L-I-O-N, 1 billion will be equals to how much? If I try to follow the same rule, that it will be 10 100 million, because it will be the just left column after this. So this will be 10 100 million. If I just further break it down, it will be how much? 10, and this is 100 million, so this is 10 into 100 million, that is 1000 million. So 1 billion is equals to 1000 million. Now, if I try to find out that this is equals to how many crores, can I find out? First, let me write down 1000 million in numeral form. We will start with, this is 1 tens 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, 1 million, 10 million, 100 million, 1000 million. So this is the numeral form of this. Now if I try to find out this in crores, I'll discuss how to convert from one system to another system. For here, what we will do, we will just underline the numbers. See, in the Indian number system, the first period, that is ones, will consist of three digits. So first we will underline this first 3 digit. The next period is 1000, and that will be of 2 digit. So we will underline this 2. Again, the next period will be lakhs, so we will underline this 2. And then it is crore, so we will underline this 2. Now if I try to write it down in Indian system, it will be, these 2 zeros comes here, again this 2 zero will come down, again this 2 zero will come down, and here the 1 will come. Let's just recheck. This is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 zeros. This is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 zeros. Perfect. So now if I try to put the commas here after the interval of every period, what do I get? So this will be 1 tens 100 thousand 10 thousand lakh 10 lakh 1 crore 10 crore. This is 100 crore. I hope this is clear. So 1 billion is equals to 1000 million, that is equals to 100 crore. So as we have already discussed here, so let's just take some more example of converting one system to another system. I'll take some random examples. Suppose this is given 7 8 5 2 3 3 4 5 1. By looking into the number, you must be able to say now that it is following which system. See, the commas are given at the interval of 3 digits. That means it is following the international number system. So before going into the conversion, I just forgot to take one example following the international number system. So as this example is already taken, so let's just try to read out this number in international number system. So this will be 785,233,451. I'll repeat once more. This is 785,233,451. Okay, now let's try to convert this number in Indian number system. For doing that, what we will do first is we will underline the numbers, underline the digits in the number according to the periods following the Indian number system. So the first period in Indian number system has three digits, so these three digits will come together. The next period after this, all the periods will be consisting of two digits, so we will just underline two digits together. So now if I try to write this number in Indian number system, this will be 78,52,33,451. I'll repeat once more. This will be 78,52,33,451. Similarly, let's take one example in Indian number system and we will convert it into international number system. So here also we will follow the same methodology, but here we will, while numbering the digits in the number, we will underline three digits together. So the first period will be consisting of three digits here. It will come, the next three digits it will be here, and the last three digits will be here. So it will look somewhat like this. And if I try to read out the number now, it will be 283,748,381. So I think you have understood up to this much. This is the main part in this chapter, the number system and the place values related with it. The next topic that we will discuss is expanded form. So in the expanded form, I have already taken here one example. Okay, if a number is given like this and you are asked to write it in expanded form, if nothing is mentioned, you will take Indian number system. Okay, so the first few steps will be similar. What we will do, we will put commas according to the number system, Indian number system. So if I just put the commas here, so the commas are done. Next, what we will do, I'll write the number once more here for your convenience. Okay, so remember, the first step, we have written the number once and we have put the commas according to the Indian number system. Next, what you will do, you will just write the place values of each of these digits in shorthand above the number. So this is ones, this is tens, this is hundred, this is thousand, this is 10,000, this will be lakh, this is 10 lakh, this is crore, this is 10 crore. Okay, now we have written the place values. Now we will try describing the digits according to the place values. So this will be what? This is 2, 10, crore, 3 crore 4 10 lakh 7 lakh 5 10,000 6,000 200 hundredths 3 tens and 7 ones. Okay, now if I as we have written it here, now we will just write it in the numeral form, and that will be our final step. 210 crore, be very careful while writing this because you may mess around with the number of zeros, so better to start from the right hand side. So this will be, this is ones, this is tens, this is hundred, this is thousand, this is 10,000, this is lakh, this is 10 lakh, this is crore, and here it is 10 crore. So this is 210 crore plus. You will write plus symbol here. Then crore like this way only you will follow. So we'll not make mistake, and better to put commas. The chances of committing mistake will be less. So crore, this is ones, tens, hundred. Like this way, this will go on. 14 lakhs, 1,000, this is 10,000, this is lakh, this is 14 lakh, then 7 lakh. I am writing from this side, but you will not write from this side. Then we have 5 10,000, then we have 6,000, then we have 200, and then 3 tens, and then 7. So this is the final expanded form of this number. So if you are given a number like this, and if you are asked to convert it into the expanded form, what it will be expected from you to write something like this. This is the final answer. Okay, and this was the steps that I was discussing, so that it will be easier for you and you'll commit less mistake. But this is the final answer. So in the other way, if the compact form, if you are asked to write down the compact form, and if this is given, this is the expanded form. By compact form, what I mean is, suppose an example is given like this, okay, and you are asked to write down the compact form of this given question. By compact form, we mean just a numeral form that previously we have taken example. So here the commas are already given, but if the commas are not given, you put commas in the numbers first. Suppose here a comma is not given, so I'll give a comma here. According to the Indian number system, I'll put the commas. So next, what we will do is, after seeing a question like this, what you will do is you will just write down the place values in shorthands, that is 1 10 hundreds 1,000 10,000 lakhs 10 lakh crore and 10 crore. Now we will see in the question and try to find out the place value of each of this number, and we'll put the digits accordingly under this place values. Okay, so here see, this is how much this is. This is ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, crore. So this is 7 crore. So I'll put 7 here. This is how much? 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000. This is lakh. Actually, I was hoping to give one more zero here. So this is 1,10,000. This 1,10,100,000, 10,000. This is lakh and this is 10 lakh. So I'll put 8 here. This is 1,10,100,000, 10,000. This is lakh. 1,10,100,000, 10,000. So I'll put 5 here. Similarly, this is 2,000. So I'll put 2 here. And this is 200. So I'll put 2 here. This is 30. That means 3 tens. That is 3 here. And 7. And we are done. So the final answer will be 2. So this is the compact form of your question. Okay, so our second part of the chapter is also done, that is the expanded form and the compact form. Next, what we will do, the rest of the part is very easy. Next, we will try to find out the successors and predecessor of any number. So successor and predecessor, when we are talking about successor and predecessor, successor means what? So this is my number 458, and if I am asking you to find the successor of this, this means what? Whenever you will heard the word successor, you will simply calculate in your mind to add 1. What you will do? You will just add 1 to this number and the answer will be 459. Okay, and similarly for predecessor, what we will do, the same number we will take 458. For predecessor, we will just minus 1 from this number and the answer will be 457. So the successors and predecessors of the number 458 is 458, successor is 459, and the predecessor will be 457. Okay, now to take this as your homework, find the successor of nine nine nine. Find the predecessor of 1. Let me see how you can do this. The concept is same. For successor, you will have to add 1, and for predecessor, you will have to minus 1 from each of this number. Okay. So, we have reached to the last part of our chapter, that is ascending and the descending order. Before moving into this part, first, I will just discuss. I know you all know this, but suppose if two numbers are given, I'll first try to derive which one is the larger number. For doing this, first we will count the number. Suppose I'll take first examples. Suppose we have this. You have these two numbers and I asked you to find the larger number among this. When you have first, what you will do, your first approach will be to count the number of digits present in this number. See here, if I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits. Here we have 6 digits and here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we have 5 digits. These are the number of digits. So the number that will be having more number of digits will be greater than the other number. So in this way we will put, I'm putting the greater sign here, you'll write it again and you'll put it there. So this number is greater than this number. Now what if the number of digits are same? Suppose I have, let us take another example. Suppose I have 2 numbers. I'll put the commas. See here, the number of digits are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the number of digits are same. When the number of digits are same, what we will do, we will start tallying the number from the left hand side. We will see that whether this, we will, the first digit here and the first digit here. If we will check on these digits that whether these are same or these are different. See, these are same. This 5 and this 5 are same. Then this 2 is same. This 3 is same. When we move on to the next digit, which is in 100 place, then we have a difference here. Here it is 4 and here we have 5. So up to this, this is same. But here there is a difference. Here it is 4 and here it is 5. So I need to bother about the number from here. And as 5 is greater than 4, 5 is greater than 4. So for obvious reason, your this number will be greater than this number. So your answer will be 523591 greater than 523497. Okay, so in this way you can find out which number is greater than the other if the number of digits are same. Now ascending and descending order. Ascending and descending order, by this, if you don't want to make confusion, whenever you will hear this word, think of a mountain. Okay, when you hear the word ascending, this means I'm moving up the mountain. Okay, moving up the mountain means what? From the smaller height you are going to the greater height. That means ascending means smaller to greater number. Ascending means smaller to greater. Similarly for descending, you will think of coming down from the mountain. So when you are coming down from the mountain, you are coming from a higher, greater height to a lower height. So this will be the vice versa. For descending, it will be greater to smaller number. Okay, now let us take some example. Suppose 5 sets of number are given and you are asked to arrange the number in descending order. So I have taken an example consisting of 5 set of numbers. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers are given and I am asked to arrange this number in descending order. Descending order means from the greater to smaller side we will go. So when you see this kind of question, first you see, look at the numbers first. See whether the commas are given or not in each of these numbers. In the first number I have given the comma, but in the next numbers the commas are not given. So first you put the commas so that you don't commit any mistake. I'm following the Indian number system. Next step, what you will do, you will write down the place value of the number system that you are following. 1 stands 100. I'm following the Indian number system. So this will be 1000. This is 10,000, this is lakh, this is 10 lakh, this is crore, this is 10 crore. Okay. Next, what you will do, you will take the numbers and you will put it under these columns. So see, if I read out this number, this will be, this is 1, 10, 100,000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh. So this is 56, this is 5, 10 lakh. So this is here, 5, 6, 2, 7, 3, 2, 8. In this way, all the numbers we will write. So next number, I can see this is 5 crores. So this is 5, 5, 6, 2, 7, 7, 8, 4. Next will be 56 lakhs 32,000 281. Then we have 32,000 284. And the last one is 4 crore. So once we are done writing the number according to their place values, now we will see we have here, we have two numbers in crores. This is 5 crore 56 lakhs 27,784. This is 4 lakhs 4 crore 20 lakhs 27,784. So this is greater than this. So according to the descending pattern. So we will write here A. This is the largest number. This is B. This is second largest number. Next we will find out. See, next we have these numbers in 10 lakhs places. So this is 56. These two numbers are same. These two digits are same. So here we will see this has got a different digit. So this is 2, this is 3. So as we have already discussed earlier, so this will be the next larger number. So here I will write C, then this will be D, and the last one will be E. See, after writing in this way, then you will write all the numbers in a line and you will give the greater sign between them and you will write down your answer. This will be your final answer. According to the numbers that we have already given, A, B, C, D, E, I have just written down the numbers here. See, this is number A, 5, 5, 6, 2, 7, 7, 8, 4, and I have given just the greater signs here, and this will be your final answer, that this is following the descending order. So students, that was all about your first chapter, that is large numbers. I hope you all have understood whatever I said, but if you still have some doubts about anything, we can always discuss. Thank you. Have a nice day.